The Strokes' first two albums are now considered classics. The general consensus from the ever-so-perfect music press is that Is This It and Room on Fire are some of the best rock albums of all time. That's a pretty good 1-2 punch if you ask me. However, even though Room on Fire is now seen as a classic album, at the time of its release, Room on Fire was seen as a noticeable step down and letdown in relationship to their debut. 20 years on, it's hard to say which album is superior, but I won't go there because I'll never return. Those immediate reviews for Room on Fire were quite underwhelming, and this left the band in a very tough situation. Do they continue writing catchy melodic rock cuts that feel vintage yet modern, and in turn risk falling down the dreaded path of diminishing returns? Or do they change it up big time? Well, I really don't know what they did. To be honest, I simply can't tell you. Maybe you guys can tell me. Let's compare The Strokes performing their brand new album in 2003, and then The Strokes performing their brand new album in 2006.
Well, we're like this band, right? You may have heard of them.
Sound like Strokes. Danny Warhol's guy.
And, you're watching the show.
Recording sessions for First Impressions of Earth went on for a very long time, starting in January 2005 and ending in October of the same year. The original plan was to record the album with Gordon Raphael, the man behind the first two albums, but somewhere along the way, the group decided to switch directions and work with David Kahn, who Albert met through his friend Sean Lennon, of Lennon fame. As a result of that, the album has two producers, but Kahn does the heavy lifting. Kahn, who had worked with big names such as Paul McCartney, Tony Bennett, and Sublime, had a distinguishable influence on the record. With that being said, Julian is known to be a perfectionist, so it's not as if he didn't still have a big say in the production of LP3. First Impressions doesn't sound like the first two records in four big ways. One, the production is clearer. All the instruments are much more discernible in the mix, and Julian's voice isn't buried in effects. Two, the band has never sounded this heavy. Sure, songs like Take It or Leave It and Reptilia have an abrasive sound, but none of the songs on those first two records get anywhere near as heavy as Juicebox, Vision of Division, or Eyes of the World. Three, it's a much longer album. Whereas the first two records kept it short and sweet with about a 35-minute runtime, First Impressions of Earth crosses the 50-minute mark, with a total of 14 tracks. Four, it's their most eclectic track list ever, going from breezy melodic numbers like Razor Blade to the insane rage of Vision of Division to the somber and reflective Ask Me Anything. This is an album that carries the core attributes of the band: catchy melodic choruses, interwoven guitar playing, Julian waiting, but it's undeniably a different beast than those first two albums.
So, thanks for showing us all the love and, all the people that voted and to the future of music and blah, blah, blah. Have a good night. Thank you.
The best Strokes album to work out to is First Impressions of Earth, and it's not even close. Half the record is made up of Swole Boy anthems. Personally, I love that the band changed it up so much on LP3. Monotony is boring, and there is no denying that this album is a different animal than the first two. We get to hear the incredible scream of Julian, which was hidden in the shadows on those first two albums, and sadly on the three that followed. We also get the most insane shredding of Nick and Albert's career here. I'm talking, you know what I mean? On that note, let me sidetrack for a second. Nothing would make me happier than the next Strokes album bringing back some of those chaotic vibes that Impressions provided. To me, it's the band's most underutilized strength. I don't see it happening, but I do pray. All in all, there are two gripes I have with this album. One, the production isn't great. I love that the instruments are all very clear, I'm talking New Abnormal level clean, but sadly the mixing isn't always right. I hear the audio clip a lot. To be honest, I don't know the difference between mixing and production. Are they the same thing? Are they different? I fucking don't know. But it clips, and you'll hear the clips! 2. As someone who is extremely bitter about how few Strokes songs have been released in their now 22-year discography, it's quite shocking that I would have the audacity to say that this album is a bit bloated. But it is. I'm not saying that some songs should have never been released, but rather released on an EP like Future, Present, Past, B-sides, or bonus tracks. Just imagine this album without On the Other Side, Ask Me Anything, Fear of Sleep, and 15 Minutes. Now it's a beautiful 10-song album. Sadly for me, this isn't what happened. Now people are going to say things like, well, you know, I would pick the other songs off the album. I would do these songs. I would kick off Killing Lies. All right, to each their own, but I think we can all agree it's a bit long. All in all, the album is full of classic Strokes cuts, as well as many very, 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 very great Strokes songs. So I'm not trying to be a hater. First Impressions of Earth serves as a great middle ground for the insanity that Julian would unleash on his two albums with The Voids, and the more straightforward, melodic sensibilities of a classic Strokes song. Personally, I would say this album slaps, and I want it to let you slap you. You'll be happier after it slaps you. I promise.